There it goes. Think we're live now. Hi, everyone. Syndrel here, and welcome to the next project. Something completely different from Cook, Serve, Delicious, which was a blast to do. If you haven't checked that out, check out the first stream project, Cook, Serve, Delicious. It was a blast. We had a ton of fun. But let's talk about the next project that I'm going to do. This is Doom and Destiny. Now, I have marked this, and I'll mark these videos with during when they go up on YouTube with the 17 plus tag, because this is a more mature type game. It got the mature rating for it. It's got some crude jokes, some more adult jokes, so not something I typically have on the channel, though we do have a couple of games that aren't totally family friendly, which is kind of the hallmark of the channel for the most part. Like, I do have BioShock, which has some more mature themes, Dead Space, and a few others that are more mature, but I have plenty of family friendly stuff on there as well. This will be one of those that are more mature. Like I said, it has the mature rating, so I threw up the 17 plus tag just for you older folks out there that have kids and kind of watch what they watch. So there's that. So this is Doom and Destiny. It is a parody RPG. Now, what do I mean by that? It's an RPG that makes fun of RPGs and various other things. I know there's some anime references. There's some other video game references that aren't necessarily RPGs. I have not played this all the way through. In fact, I only got to play a little bit of it, because I had this on my Xbox 360 when it was I believe it was a Summer of Arcade title. But it was a indie game on Xbox Live Arcade. And I tried it out, I was having a ton of fun with it, and that is when my Xbox 360 decided to die. So I never got that far in this game. Then, it's on Steam. It's on Steam now. Now, there is another game, Doom and Destiny Advance, which I might do right after this one, depending on how people like this. So, chat, and those of you that are viewing these later and check them out, let me know what you think about the game, and I'll pick up Doom and Destiny Advance. I don't own it. It's like 10 bucks on Steam, somewhere around there. RPGs that make fun of RPGs, this could be epic. The little bit I played was absolutely hilarious. So, obviously it's D&D. So the first thing we're gonna kind of poke a little fun at is something that I used to play a lot of, and I know some of you in chat do, is Dungeons and Dragons. There is Chillax, Classic, and Hardcore, and for your difficulty levels. I don't know how tough this game gets, but I'm going to play on Classic. And maybe I can change it later if it gets too hard, and we'll just Chillax. The story we're about to tell is fictionary. All characters, events appearing in this work are fictitious. Any resemblance to real persons, living or undead, is purely coincidental. Purely coincidental. Right, Knight? So already the game is giving you kind of the tongue-in-cheek that you need to take with this game. That is one thing that you need to take with this game. It is very tongue-in-cheek. You gotta laugh with this game, you gotta have fun with it. That's what I'll say right off the bat. You have to have fun with this game. Any references it makes, You know, anything it pokes fun at, you know, whatever, you gotta have fun with it. You gotta laugh with me. Because I'll be laughing at all the jokes that I get. So, just put that in front. And also, one last thing. Again, this was rated mature, in for mature. So, you have little ones or whatever. I put the 17 plus tag on these for a reason. Whether you feel it's justified at the end of the day or not, I don't know, because I don't know the whole game. But, that is my disclaimer. You got it. So, now I'm in the clear. That's the disclaimer. I've said it twice in the first 6 minutes. Think I'm good. Ready, set, go! And I remember this part too, so, again, I already gave the 17 plus disclaimer, alright? Like, if you're serious about that, Lou, like, you probably should not, you probably should not be here. Like, I'll just be serious, just for a minute, you know, 17 plus, I really mean that. Because again, I have this image, and it's more than just an image. I do keep a lot of stuff on the channel family friendly. I really do. But not everything is that way, and this game won't be. So, alright, just, I'm just being truthful and upfront with all of you. That's how I am. Alright, hope you're all ready. Just hold on tight. We'll have some fun with this. I guess I could do some voice acting. I tend to not do as much with the streams just because it's more me kind of having fun. But my lord, preparations have been finished. Excellent. Is the flux capacitor at maximum power? Absolutely, my lord. And the four elemental mana crystals overflow with energy, my lord. Hey, I held one of those, by the way. Final Fantasy 1 LP reference. So you can see, already, we're already getting the references. Four elemental mana crystals that overflow with energy. It's a Final Fantasy 1 reference. There are, from what little bit I've played, there are tons of references. See how many you can get. Now I'll try to point them out along the way. Sounds almost like a oh, this is far from a Final Fantasy game, Dante. Welcome. By the way, 17 plus tag, just in case. I don't know your age, but the 17 plus tag is there. So. Marvelous! My plan is finally coming together. The gates to the Ultra World are about to be opened! We just need a virgin's blood, and then this universe will be mine! Oh, 35. Oh, okay. Then you're very cool. So we're already sacrificing a virgin in this game. How crazy is that? Actually, I had such dreadful expectations from this experiment that last night had a party and... What? Yep, great party. It was awesome, bro. Got laid. No way. Me too. High five. This cannot be! Oh man, when the last part of your experiment goes wrong. Episode 1, Cellars and Lizards. And that's the kind of game we're gonna have, ladies and gentlemen. So, buckle up. We're in for a ride. Alright, I'm already getting some laughs. Good, great. Loving already. Good. I'm glad. Awesome role-playing, Big Knight. Hope we'll start a new D&D campaign. I'm so excited. I don't know why the screen is blinking either. I apologize for that. You shouldn't be doing that. Calm down, Nigel. Benjamin, the Game Master, told me that he wanted to play something different. Something that's not the usual D&D. What? Are you sure, Mike? Like, I don't have that many different voices for these guys, so it's just going to be me. Crap, I spent the entire afternoon filling out the character sheet for tonight. Alright, not blinking on this end. Oh, good, okay. Then it's just me. I'm fine with that then. Spent the afternoon filling out the character sheet for tonight. How many of us have been there? You fill out a character sheet and then, no, we're going to do this instead. I'm raising my hand. Easy, Johnny. Yeah, Francis is right. Chillax, Johnny. It's just a game. Last time I heard the master, he told me exactly the same. Wants to play something new. Come on, guys, let's go inside. Use the arrow keys to move your hero around. Hold left shift to walk. You run naturally, which is really good. Z is the interact. I'm going to be using keyboard for this. Escape opens up the in-game menu, like so. So, options. I think the volume's okay. I'm going to turn down the sound a little bit because of the crickets. So we're going to go a little less for it. That sounds pretty good. Font. You can have different font, by the way. Just some of the crazy things that are in this game. You have, like, Andy, more gothic, like you have 5 different fonts, so you can have fonts. Isn't this game done by the creators of last stream? I don't know who does this game, actually. It might be this is nowhere near the same style as last stream, though. I think all of you already got that going. There's a whole bunch of different fonts. I'm just gonna go white and border white, actually. Because it's my LP. Well, not LP, sorry. My stream. I don't see the font, the border color changing yet, anyway. I want it to be orange. Escape opens the menu. Okay. See if that changes it. If not, oh well. Nigel's car. I can't open up the menu yet, but a stash of consumers' complaints. Seems like Benjamin doesn't care about it that much. Yes, yeah, so many different color options, by the way. Female character in the lab scene looked... Well, this I know this is an RPG Maker game. So, some of the assets could be reused from RPG Maker. We have found a Panino! I'm not joking. Those are gonna be, like our healing items will be, like, food and stuff. It's great. Nothing! That's right, you open the treasure chest to get nothing. We have a shovel! Why'd we pick up the shovel? It might be useful. Shit, in a mock. Good. Hey, could be useful. I want to try to get as much of the... But is nothing better than a mimic? Yes. Well, it depends on what the mimic has. No answer. Well, why don't we go through the creepy door in the back? You know, that's already open. This one. Is this Benjamin's cellar? Well, it is where that should be. This is different than usual. Guys, did you notice these dragon statues? Yeah, they're neat. The place looks cleaner. Hey, yeah, you're right. Guys, these statues are strange. Haven't seen them before. Perhaps they're just scenery parts of Benjamin's game. Yeah, that's why he cleaned the whole room. Awesome! Oh boy. No, you see, I also have dragon statues. If you get, come and visit sometime, and play D&D with me, I have, dragon statues just like that. It's just part of the scenery, promise. Not evil or anything at all. Loca-Cola. Potato chips. Nothing. What is this stuff? Door is locked. You need the red key. That's weird. Door of the Game Master's playroom is locked. It says we need a red key. This stuff looks like a bunch of instructions for a role-playing game. Doom and Destiny. D&D? Boring. So do you want to hear it or not? Yeah, I really want to. Looks like a standard RPG. You gotta go around, collect keys, open doors and chests, apparently even wardrobes and closets, kill monsters to upgrade to new levels through experience points. Ain't that cool? Yeah, sounds good. Breaking the fourth wall? No, it's in the book, right there in front of us. Go back to the upgrading part. How's that work? Says that when you gain a new level, the player can use 3 points to increase the 4 main abilities. Might, Charisma, Grit, and Dexterity. Any special powers? Let me see. Yes, it says that you can find and buy special powers for each character that you want equipped and remove whenever you want. Still, in order to be equipped, each power requires a certain number of power points, which are based on ability scores. So, the higher my ability scores are, the more power points I get, and the more powers I can equip. Yeah, you're right. I'm amazed. 1 power point when a base ability hits 15. Another when it hits 21, 28, 36, 45, and so on. Yeah, sounds easy. And it's actually easier than you think, because when you see how you put the points in, it'll be marked when you get the power points. Cool. In order to avoid messing up, as we usually do when we play an RPG... Oh yeah, none of my friends are in chat now. Aww. We have to decide which role each of us should pick. Excuse me. I'll play a super sorcerer, warlock, leader, badass hero with high charisma. So, as you can see the colors of the clothes they're wearing and how charisma is blue. It's to help you remember their main stat. Okay. Look what I found here, a power for my class. Nigel learned magic missile. Now, we all know magic missile, right? You're used to that. Magic missile. It's not going to be that kind of magic missile, I assure you. I didn't mean it that way. I met my friends here in town that I, play D&D with, I hang out with on Tuesdays. Jeez. Yes, Nuka-Cola. Get it? But it's Loca-Cola. Anyway. Looks like a rocket. Yeah, it kind of does, doesn't it, Maze? Wait till I cast it. Not the magic missile you are thinking of. Like your typical magic missile in, D&D and stuff. Anyway. Lucky bastard. Now I can cast magic missile if I equip this power. Come on, try it. So, tutorial time. By the way, it's not gold, it's goals. Powers. Go to the person you want to have equip it. Go to Nigel. He has 1 power point. Magic missile takes 1 power point to equip. A must for every spellcaster. I know y'all are joking. It is a must for every spellcaster, though. Every spellcaster knows magic missile. It's a thing. Usable only in battle. 1 opponent. 1 power point to equip. Costs 29 turns because it goes by like a tick system. The battle, you'll see. 25 MP to cast. It does 40 to 60 HP worth of damage. No special abilities. There we go. Awesome. I want to play a fighter with tons of might. I'll be a nimble and honorable ninja. Dexterity is my second name. Mike, you're the last one. We need a healer. Why don't you play a cleric? That's my role. It's the role I'm always playing. It's me. That's me. Aren't cleric spellcasters as well? They can't use it. That's true. Because it's usually an arcane spell, not a divine spell. When you go to, when you go to D&D, Eagle Claw says that. Also, I'm gonna love having you all in chat. 1d4 plus 1. Because magic missile. you got that, you kind of picked up on that, huh, Knight? It's fine. Yeah, why don't you play a cleric? Because, you know, that person that's last always gets stuck playing the healer. Need a healer. Exactly. Need a healer. Yeah, without a healer, it gets really hard playing an RPG. I'm a pirate! What? Are you nuts? You can't be a pirate while I'm a ninja? There's a chance that all life as you know it would instantaneously stop and that every molecule in your body explodes at the speed of light. Because as we all know, pirates and ninjas can't get along. It's a thing. He is right. Whatever he said. Plus we need a healer. Come on. What about a cool paladin devoted to a mighty and vengeful god? Fine with that. Well, what about a pirate who's a paladin of a god who is a huge flying monster made of spaghetti? Whatever. Yeah, the important thing is, don't mess up everything as usual. One last thing. We need a leader. Yeah. Why? Because during a battle, according to where we decide to fight, whether up front or to the rear line, the leader can give different types of bonuses. And what if I want to stay in the middle? No bonuses for those who stay in the middle. Being the most charismatic guy of our party, as a leader, I'd boost mana and spirit. Get the feeling I'm lagging behind. It's possible. Pastafarian Paladin. What a pussy. Being the strongest among us, I'd boost health and strength. What a bunch of slowpokes. Real deal is evasion and speed. What about you, Mike? I don't know. Come on, make up your mind. I think grit is the most important quality in an adventurer, so I think I'd boost resistance to unfavorable states and critical hit. What? Yeah, you know, resistance to poisoning, confusion, burning, abilities down, so on and so on and so on, and chance to double your damage with the critical hit. Sounds useless. You're useless! Don't expect my help when the evil jinxing monsters hit you. Come on, let's choose the leader. okay. So, to choose a leader, you choose somebody to be up front. For me, being the mage that I am, I'm going to choose Nigel, who is a Magi. Warrior, pirate, ninja. So, there are your leaders. Now, depending on who the leader is, they will boost or lower the stats depending on where you are. So, for example, if... with Nigel as the leader, if you're up front, you gain spirit, don't remember what spirit does exactly, but you lose MP. But if you're in the back, you lose spirit, but gain MP. So it just depends on where you want your party members. No bonuses for those in the middle. So, if you're in the middle, no bonuses, but no minuses either. So I'm putting Nigel in the back for more MP, and for right now, everybody else can stay there. More MP because missile. Awesome! I was born to be leader. Red shirt, we know who dies first then. Plus, he's the warrior. That's like double bad. He's a red shirt warrior. Think about that. Okay, I think we're done. But I'll take these handbooks with us, just in case we need to revise the rules of the game, aka you need to go over the instructions again. Press X to open the menu, and now we have access to the menu. So you can pull up these options again, save the game. You can save the game anywhere. As you can see, I played a little bit of this myself. We'll save there. Powers, etc., etc. Potato chips. Burr. We have burr. And a hammer. Awesome, a hammer. So manly. Stats of old 80s porn mags. But nothing useful here. Alright, let's get people with actual equipment. It's Hamaton! Dun-na-na-na. Anyway. Yes, that was needed, by the way. We'll give the warrior the hammer, and we also have a shovel. Oh, the shovel does more. Give the warrior the shovel. And give the ninja a hammer. Alright. Kind of a random items are our weapons right now. Gonna refresh, I'm way behind. Oh, okay, sorry. I'll just go with that. You can check status and you see whatever it is. Our equipment right now is polo. Blue polo. And of course the hammer and equipment that other people have. Might affects strength and HP. Charisma affects magic and spirit. Oh, spirit is your magic damage. That's right, I believe. But more MP. Grit affects your resistance and critical evasion. Or your critical hit, excuse me. And dexterity affects your evasion and your speed in combat. There you go. I love the way they did this. It's very simple. And you can see the stat that you have at each. 13 might, 15 charisma, 12 grit, 11 dex. Alright. Yeah. Well, we'll be average for now. Till I decide, kind of see how everything goes. Alright. Let's move on. Holy crap, a skeleton! What's up? What's up? Anyway. Awesome, it's talking! Let's kick its ass before it manages to change our minds. Ah! Dodged! And we get into combat. It is a standard... I need to lower music just a little bit. So the screen's gonna go black for a little bit. There we go. Yes, guy has a lava basement under his house. Alright, this plays like a standard RPG at this point. You have skill, you have an attack command, guard command, item command, plays like that. Warrior, go swing. Now you get an estimation of how much damage you're going to do. Skeleton has 30 HP. Does 26. That's what the red bar was. You can see how much damage you would do. And done. Super friends, we're victorious. Yeah, these guys weren't a match for the great Nigel. And we got 5 EXP. Gold, gold. Always believe in your soul. We got 2 goals, and unfortunately no useful item was found. So 2 money. Side quest. Yes, there are side quests. There are a bunch of side quests. Dead or alive? It's a load of fun, you know, having side quest. I believe this side quest is undead kills. So how many undead kills do you have? We get stuff when we complete it. Freaking fun! We beat a skeleton! This is lava! Starting to doubt that this is only a setting. Yeah, think? Why don't we move on? What was that? Did you hear something? Random encounters. Oh, welcome back, Doc! This is Doom and Destiny. It's an RPG that makes fun of RPGs and other things, like animes and stuff. It's gonna be a lot of fun. Quit freezing, Twitch, I agree. Yeah, that sound you heard? Random encounters. Those little fuckers hate random encounters. Press left control in battle to use the turbo button. Your party will blindly attack the first target at double game speed. Press space in battle to show the battle log. You know, in case you want to get through something super fast. This way. Because we all hate random encounters. They're not fun. Hey, skeletons! Sounds so strange hearing Syndra say adult words. Sorry. I told you this is gonna be. This will be 17 plus. I made no bones about it. Need much more than that to hurt me? Eh, something new to play with. Money. Ahoy! And other nautical expressions because he's the pirate. Tankard. You know what the tankard is? Half shield, half weapon, half full? That's right, counts as a shield. We shall give it to the warrior. It also gives you plus 10 HP. How about that? Yeah, found a 2x4. That's right, it's a 2x4. Wooden board, smashing enemies since 1988. The 2x4 is actually weaker than the hammer or the shovel, because, you know, grip. No, I know Eagle Claw, but now I'm worried about the people that might be offended. I'm kind of scared. Because, you know, family-friendly channel. What do you think, chat? Kind of scared. You're not offended, loser. Doc saying he's offended. Hi, Fane. Welcome to Doom and Destiny. I don't know your age, but note the 17 plus tag on the stream, because this is going to be a more mature game. So, just fair warning, I'm kind of warning people as they come in. Let's give the pirate 2x4. Why not? Nothing here. Got a rope. It's not like we have to pick up everything we found on the ground. Jeez. I can put a mature warning up on YouTube also. Yeah, I can. Does it look mature? Oh, it is. I guarantee it. And pizza! By the way, potato chips, salty and unhealthy, gives you 85. Couldn't a pirate use the taker? That's true. Maybe we'll get another one. potato chips gives you 75 HP back. Pizza gives you 150. Real slice of Italian pizza. And the panino gives you 300 HP back, because sandwich. More like immature. Yeah, I guess so. And yes, you have to pick up everything. It's a Doc, you're with me on this 100%. You gotta pick up everything in games. Everything. Loca-Cola, great hot with biscuits, gives you 75 MP back, because drink. And Burr gives you 150, cold and refreshing as you always want it. Gives you 150 MP back. Inside there is 25. Yes, loot is the key to everything. Exactly. 25 cash. Hi, skeletons. Ow. And Stella tank, because more HP, so it's a tank. Oh, critical hit. You're dead. Now, why don't I go ahead and show off magic missile? You know, because it's a magic missile. I know what you're thinking. Here's magic missile, though. Magic missile! Yes, I literally just shot a missile at him. Thumbs up! EXP for everybody. You divvy out the EXP, I think. I don't think everybody gets the same. By the way, bone, because skeleton. And more undead is, well, they're dead again. Doc's still playing No Man's Sky. He's in a galaxy. That's pink. That's cool. Magic missile. Yeah, it is truly a magic missile. never heard of this game. It was a Xbox Live title back. It's on Steam now. It's got a mature tag just because of the jokes and stuff. And, It's a pretty good RPG from what I've played of it as well. But the best way I can put it, it's an RPG that makes fun of RPGs. It's got a bunch of references to games, they make fun of them. It's one of those type of games. Just a little bit more damage. Up top, you can see the time bar, by the way. And the thing I like, you can also see where the character is going to go, depending on what they do. Very useful. Money. 4 stars. The magic of the missile is figuring out where it was fired from. No, I summoned it. It's cool. Broken bottle of wine. Nothing useful here. An actual bottle of wine. Wine, blood of the god, Bacchus. Heals 300 MP because wine. Not this one. The baby dragon is not here. And we found a secret. Money, 50. So 150 cash. Yes, there are secrets. We're going to be trying to find as many of them as we possibly can. Oh, I should have hit this one. I did not pay attention to turn order. My bad. That's what potato chips are for. Yeah, no baby dragons allowed. Not for this game. More bones. Plus 4! I believe everybody gets 4 more. Oh no, we get 4 of these items. When you finish a quest, like side quests like that, you kill enough enemies or do whatever. You get items and stuff. We got 4 one-ups. What a hero needs when he's KO'd. Need an extra life. So, one-up. Bones can be used as weapons. Ugh. And the 2x4 is actually the weakest weapon we have. Because, you know, it doesn't have grip. Though, I think a 2x4 is a good weapon. I have played a little bit of this game, but nowhere near all of it. That's why I say it's semi-blind. I've played, I don't know, a couple of hours of the game. And, like, the first time I had it on to the story again real quick. For the new people in chat, I had this game on Xbox 360 because I said it was an Xbox Live game, and I played the start of it, got a little ways in, and then my 360 broke. Like, just terrible timing. And I never got to play it again, bought it on Steam, tested out to make sure it worked, and haven't played it since, so... you would have got a huge kick out of the beginning, Doc. I can guarantee that. All right, let's head to the right. Pro tip, save often. You can do it from the menu screen or pause screen. It might have been Eagle Claw. I don't get all the references, but there's a lot of them here. So now the game is telling you to save. Guess what you should do? I'm just saying. These signs right here would be useful for our friend Sir Gun Gun. Right here, these signs. These. Cause he forgets to save a lot. Hey, sunglasses. Looking sharp, looking for love. This raises spirit, so we're gonna give him to the mage. And we can beat up the skeleton here. The battle music gets really loud. And as you can see, it's now a silver star. Yes, they go more than just, there's a bronze, silver, and then probably gold, I would guess. Dead or alive. Over here, some potato chips, nothing. Wear my sunglasses at night. Anyway. As Eagle Claw said. Locked, but the opening mechanism is in another room. I wonder where it could be. Let's try the room we didn't go into. You know, the one I should have went to first. And as you can see, just that little bit of the star filled up. Just a little bit. Look, a picture of Benjamin, our game master. Look at the way he's smiling. Loser. Where the heck are you now? Tinkered. Old 80s song there, syndrome. I think that some of these references are pretty old, even like old for me, but like I think you'll all get, like, the older people will get a lot of kick out of this, and hopefully the younger people will get a kick out of the some of the jokes and stuff too. The pirate needs to have a tankard because pirate, so that has to happen. Can't push this way. What if I look at that secret passage, and then I get attacked. Skeletron and skeleton. I think you might be able to kill them. Nope, nope. Not enough. Not enough. Yeah, ow. As you can see, sometimes the enemies say stuff too. Talk smack. Almost level 2. Back off, men. I'm not a fruit ninja. Got a little passage here. Secret found. Nothing new, nothing. Money, money. Money, but get attacked. Where's Skeletor? I don't know, we may see one later. Dead. Dead or alive. And that's everything here. Potato chips. Potato chips. Nice hole. Is this the way to go ahead? All the evidences point to this. What evidences? Hey, let's use the rope we found before. Hey, rope. But first... Or maybe that is the way I... Let's check this room. I think that's the way we want to go. Pot top. From a mighty pot. And this raises evasion. We shall give it to the ninja. How that makes him more evasive, I don't know, but it does. Welcome to die. Yeah, ow. By the way, it's a Skelezard. Would you get a skeletal wizard? And that's it. Woo! Level 2! I'm by winning. Alright, you can see the big... Oh, I know what the reference is to Eagle Claw. I got that one. It is a reference to the X-Men arcade game. Welcome! That's why I kind of went into the Magneto voice. Welcome to die! Anyway. You can see the big bars. Those are your power points. So if I were to go like this, he would get another power point. And we have 3 points to put into. You can see the stats that it affects. As it might affect HP and strength. Charisma, MP, spirit, etc., etc., etc. You can build the characters how you want. Now, characters are good at certain things and have their classes. But that doesn't mean you can't divvy up the points a little bit. I'm going to put 2 into Might, so he gets that extra power point, and 1 into Charisma, because that's kind of his main stat. For Johnny, we'll put 2 into Dex and 1 into Might. My fist just got stronger. This won't buy me a drink, says the pirate. As you can see, pretty balanced. Because Mike's that way. Just balanced. It's just kind of whatever. So, but he likes grit, so we'll go 2 points in grit and 1 point into might. My technique is almost perfect, says the ninja. 2 into might and 1 into dex. Came, we saw, we kicked their asses! Now I need to high-five somebody. Anyway. Mike learned heal bruise. Wait a second. This power is not for me. Hey, come on, Mike. Equip this new power. Okay, I can do it. Guess what we just got, everybody? We just got a heal spell. A divine power capable of healing wounds. Not serious wounds, mind you, it's just heal bruise. But it does heal. Usable always on one ally, takes 1 power point, costs 28 turns, 15 MP, and heals 39 to 57. So he now takes the role of healer, even though he's a pirate. Hey, now I can heal you guys. It's worse than a lesser heal spell, Knight. Potato chips, orange juice, hey OJ, and potato chips and money. OJ from real orange juice heals 50 MP. Skeletal Wizard gets to go. Welcome to die. 1d8 plus 1 or just plus 1? Well, it's like 1d4 plus 1. Now we're talking minor heal. Better than just plus 1, though. Better than, like, stabilize. Hocus pocus, because beating up spellcasters. And And over here, cardboard helmet. Just pretend it's safe. It's utility. More HP for the ninja. Okay, I'm gonna stop right here. We're like close to an hour in. I need to take the pulse of the room. One, do you think it's okay for me to be playing this game? Just because of what people think about the channel and stuff. Like, I do have Dead Space and BioShock on my channel. Not everything is, you know, super sunshine, even though I love that a lot. You know, sometimes I need to play something else. Two, are you enjoying it so far? Answer those two things for me, chat, and I would be greatly appreciative. Down the rope we go. There's a yes. I think it's hilarious. One yes, two yes. Okay. Get the skeleton tank. I think it's fine. You'll have a disclaimer, so if someone gets upset, they went in with full knowledge. Yes on both accounts. All right, great. I'm feeling much better. Thank you. Get out. I need to meditate on our tactical flaws. So says the ninja. Where are the magic items? Gee, thanks, Alicor. And I know you're joking. All right, chat. A lot of you have played games. How many times have you screamed that out at your DM? Doc, I'm staring at you. And everybody that's played D&D. Shall of course just joking, Lou. I get it. Me. I would never. That's so not true. I remember that if I ever DM something again. You'll never ask for magical items. Monster-O-Matic. Wait! There might be a trap. Chillax. Can't be traps without a warning. What did I just read? Hey, so that's how monsters are created. It's a slime that attacked us. Might think we just steal the magic items. That's true. It's a jelly. Favorite part of the game, getting loot. So, yes, ladies and gentlemen, this is how us DMs make our monsters. We just have a lever and they just, you know, pop out like that. It's really neat. Every supervillain needs one of these. Like, why don't more villains have this? Where they just hit and, you know, flip a switch and monster. Hey, got some jelly beans because jelly. Sweet and gummy. Heals 50 HP. They're the low healing item. Go ahead and use that. And Johnny can have some potato chips. Alright, I'm done playing with slimes. Hit that to cause the door to open. I do remember that. Don't worry, the game will hint at it for you if you didn't, if you kind of missed that. Died because he hasn't bought Doom and Destiny's full version. Because there was a demo. That's the joke there. Rita from Power Rangers had similar. Oh, that's true. Rita Repulsa did have something like that. Good honor. What are you looking at? What are you looking at? Died after playing D&D for 12 hours in a row? He deserved to die. He was a douchebag. we've all had that person in our party. Died while beta testing. That is true dedication from the beta tester. Yay! Yeah, she did have that shelf of clay figures, but I mean, close enough. I mean, she kind of made her own monsters. Die. And one-shot the wizard. And bones. So far? Play 12 hours plus of D&D and I'm not dead. I mean, mentally. Died because he hacked Doom and Destiny. That's right. Pay for your games, folks. I agree wholeheartedly with that. Don't hack. Hey, a shovel. We know that's a good weapon. Dig your way through the enemies. Ninja. And then we can give the hammer. Oh, same as the bone. Use the hammer, though. Another 2x4. Died because he was dead. Died because he hacked Doom and Destiny. Died peeling a banana. It was a very big one. Died because he didn't pay attention to the electrified floor. Pay that one, actually. That one actually helps you. Didn't pay attention to the electrified floor. No, really. Watch out for the electrified floor. You know, when you're just trying to hint at your players. You know, I wonder why there's skeletons here on these purple tiles. I wonder what's going on there. Don't step on the electrified floor. You take damage. If I remember right, you take damage. Inside here, potato chips and burr. Ow! That just singed my balls! Yeah, that would hurt. Because somebody didn't press the right arrow key. For science, you should step on it. Well, guess what happens in about 15 to 30 seconds because of the string. Hear the distinctive sound of a cell door opening. This way. And there we go. Alright. Don't step on the electrified floor, kids. Not a smart thing to do. Didn't see it do it again. Whatever. Pro tip. Ow. Fight and... Doesn't matter. They're both back there at the same point. Dead. Next. Doesn't quite kill. You get one more turn. Then ninjai. Get a little bit of money. Ahoy and other nautical expressions. And... wrong person. Potato chips. Okay. That switch, of course, if you didn't figure it out, over here. Save. Save here. By the way, it told you to save, right? You know you should save. Anything hidden in these? Awesome! Now, my D&D friends, not Doom and Destiny, but Dungeons & Dragons friends, I just put a room with a whole bunch of treasure. You know. Nothing bad could possibly happen. Holy guacamole! What a treasure! Could it be a trap? Nah, I don't think so. We're low-level characters, and we don't have a rogue who could disarm traps. So there can't be any traps. Yeah, Johnny's right. Oh, what about this sword in the stone here? You have found a rusty sword. Awesome, a real sword. No, wait. I can't equip it. Looks like a weapon for a fighter. Someone like Johnny. Rusty, but a lot of style. Only Johnny can use this because he's the fighter, and it's even one better than the shovel. Start to act like a fighter. That hammer to the mage. All right. Nothing possibly could go wrong. Hey, it's the red key we need. You know, because you need keys to go through doors, Doom style. Wow, a key item. And it's a key. And red, cool. Are you still worried about the trap? Come on, Francis. Chillax a little more. Tell me once more to chillax, and I swear I'll kick your balls out of your mouth. Think about that one. And by the way, what does chillax mean? For those people that don't know what chillax means, it means you have to chill out and relax. No traps, see? Yes! I was right! And we're dead. Boss battle versus dungeon and dragon. By the way. Because. Alright, let's go. Hit, hit, magic missile. Yeah, ow. Dungeon lightning! It's dungeon lightning. Dungeon lightning. Heal Bruise, the mage! Heal a spaghetti monster! Because remember, he's a paladin of a god that is a spaghetti monster. And rats, of course it's a rat. You know, dungeon rat. Attack! I like this music, by the way. Dragon's Breath! Yeah, ow! The dragon's so cool, he can hit everybody. Ha! Dodge! I like when the character dodges, they step back. And the attack doesn't hit them. Magic Missile! Oh, there went dungeon. Now we just gotta take care of the dragon. Which is, of course, the bigger threat, but gotta save the dragon for last. Too cool. I mean, it's an actual dragon. Look at that. Heal Johnny. Heal the spaghetti monster! Yeah, you thought he was joking. Oh no, he meant that. But of course, because low-level characters has to be a weak dragon. EXP! Hey, level 4! And the others are just short, because people get slightly different EXP. By winning! Mage. 2 points into charisma, and 1 into dex. Dragon scale armor, dungeon scale vest. Well, it's fun. Double dragon. Ha, get it? Double dragons. Okay, anyway. Hey, that was fun. Awesome, we beat the dragon. And a dungeon. That's right, you just beat a dungeon. Not all dragons can be Zara. That's true. Not all dragons can be Starlight either. Whatever it was. Yeah, you just beat a dungeon. Think I pooped myself. Well, let's give people this equipment. Dragon scale armor made from real dragon scales because dragon. Of course goes to the fighter, way better than that red polo he's wearing, plus 35 HP, plus 10 MP, plus 1 resistance. And dungeon scale vest, light vest made out of real dungeon skin. Wait. It's for our dodgy character, the ninja, plus 25 MP and plus 25 HP. There you go. Pro tip, save often. And now we have the red key, so we need to head back. Tori Sidra wasn't a real dragon, it was a cosplayer. I hit the wrong skeleton. Whoops. Now I'll need to do better than that later. It does, doesn't it? But it was a dungeon. How do we have the skin of a dungeon? Anyway. Everybody else levels up. Fish just got stronger. We're going to go 2 into might and 1 into grit. 2 into grit, 1 into might. 2 into dex and 1 more into might. Yeah, but it wasn't a rat. It was a dungeon. All right, let's get out of here. And save the game. Yeah, it's not creepy at all. Does being the liver give you slightly more EXP? I don't think it does. There's something else. Like, if you get the killing blow, I think you get a little extra EXP. There's a reason they get off by a little bit. It was a rat named Dungeon by its master. That is possible. What is this place? This doesn't look like the Game Master's playroom. Benjamin! Are you there? I don't think the master will answer. What the? Santa? Okay, so you finally enter the treasure room, but a big red dragon is waiting for you, ready to attack with its deadly breath. Crap. Okay. I cast an invisibility spell on myself and try to sneak behind it. Don't do that! Dragons can smell invisible creatures! Really? Who the hell were they? So yes, it's like super creepy bad guy wizards actually playing D&D. You knew that happens. Anyway. Episode 2, Initial Fantasy. Where are we? Drive by tips? Actually, teleport by tips. Oh crap, we're naked! I can't believe it! The experiment worked! Yes, it worked! I don't know how, but everything went well! Oh, my presence here is no longer required. Yes, priest, thank you very much. Your holy words and prayers helped us all. Wait, did you ever go down that rope? Yes, I did. I did go down the rope. That's where we got the healing spell. That's where we got Heal Bruce. Wait a sec. What's going on? By the way, why are there black mages and white mages? Do you see that there are black mages and white mages in the background? Black mage up top and then white mages there. Dress that way because it's cool. And we're in Initial Fantasy. Don't worry about the cloud, it's fine. Excuse me, but aren't they supposed to be five, like the legendary five rangers of power? If you could see the smile on my face right now. Doc, are you paying attention? The legendary five rangers of power. So great. Five? You seen Benjamin? He's our game master. Well, yeah, should have been five. But even four is okay. After all, there were four of the incredible ninja mutants. Indeed, there were four of those. Yes, he is right. We should thank Destiny for those four living heroes. Heroes? Us? Living? Yes, you're heroes! Since you've survived traveling across the mystical portal, that qualifies you as heroes! Awesome! Cool! Good! Wait! First of all, what's going on?
We understand your concern. The king will explain everything to you.
To the king!
You should meet the king and buy some clothes. Good day to you, Streaker Heroes. Nice butt. I know.
You really want to impress a lady? You should use an enlarging spell.
Oh, burn! I see Wiener. That's how I'm gonna call you. So sophomoric, that one.
Should find some clothes before you catch a cold.
This was the kind white mage. This one's the nice one. Nah, I won't let you pass. You should talk to the king first. And then they start to repeat.
Hurry up!
King is waiting for him. You should talk to him if you want to start your quest.
Yeah, sure.
Oh, these fellows the five heroes?
Well, yes, your majesty, but there are only four.
I see.
They do not look as handsome as the last heroes we had, and they're half naked.
Oh, yeah, maybe they don't look like much, but they survived the journey across the portal, and this qualifies them as heroes.
Sorry to interrupt you, but we don't have a clue of what you're talking about. Where are we? Who are you?
I'm King MacGuffin, and this is my castle. You have been summoned to help us against our eternal enemy, the Unnamed.
Unnamed? Cool name!
Yes, his name is Unnamed.
Unnamed is not his name, since his real name was cursed by destiny himself.
Awesome! What's his real name?
It cannot be pronounced, since it was cursed.
Bet it's something embarrassing, like anus. Or anal bag.
But what has he done in order to become your number one enemy?
Who knows?
What?
You see, Destiny always selected some heroes able to stop the Unnamed long before he could do anything evil.
That's convenient.
So we've never known what the Unnamed was up to.
But since you're the heroes now, you'll be the ones to stop him.
But why us? We're not heroes.
Yes, you are.
What about Lord McDouche?
No, we're not.
Hank?
But you were chosen, even if pure by pure chance.
Pardon?
Well, you see, in troubled times, Destiny himself pronounces a prophecy which picks up the heroes who will save us all.
But this time, even if the Unnamed is up to something, Destiny made no prophecy.
So this time we act on our own initiative and decided to choose five heroes by pure chance. And we just hoped for the best.
What? That's the craziest thing I've heard!
Indeed, but crazy times require crazy solutions.
That's great! I wonder why you didn't select someone more apt. I don't know, like Chuck Norris. Or Bruce Campbell.
Bruce Campbell, I would love to have in the party.
This is my boomstick.
Huh, don't worry. Destiny will help us all.
Yes, once you complete your first quest, he will make you like heroes.
Wait, he? Destiny is a person?
Well, of course. He's our emperor, ruler of this world.
So yes, the ruler is Destiny, not actually like Destiny as in fate, but there's a person named Destiny. Anyway.
Hail to thee, O Destiny.
No, a name's gotta be something more evil. Something with dark in it, like dark evil. Oh boy, place is way out of my league. Dark Hank! Evil Hank? Enough of this Hank!
Now, no more delays. I let the evil wizard Orcus kidnap my daughter Zoe. His lair is hidden far east near a lake. Go there, defeat the evil Orcus, save my daughter, and become real heroes.
Yeah, right, they're not level 30. Plus, he has the Wand of Orcus, you know? One-shot kill? Takes you down to 0 HP? Anyway.
Jester!
That's right, the clown is the jester, by the way.
Yes, your majesty.
Give these young adventurers 100 gold and a world map.
So, 100 cash and a world map. Hey, a world map!
Then spread the word all around the kingdom. Let the people know that 4 heroes are about to achieve great deeds. They're now allowed to gather anything they want from each and every house, but still have to pay for their own equipment. And for the love of destiny, get them some clothes. Still naked.
And I love how the game just makes that decree. You know, that weird RPG logic where we can just take everything from any home or anything we want because we're heroes, but we still have to pay for everything. Yeah.
But the king has decreed it, so it shall be so.
As an RPG fan, that gets me. It gets me so well.
Yes, your majesty.
I got it. Darkadeus! Holy frying shit! Did you see that? It was so cool! Freaking awesome! So the unmatchable name was Darkadeus!
Stop it! That name cannot be pronounced! Now leave! Save my daughter and fulfill your destiny!
Fulfill the Emperor? Also puppy, yes, as Knight points out, puppy. That is jumping up and down, having a good time. So yeah, Destiny, so fulfill the Emperor?
No, your fate, karma, whatever. Be gone.
That lightning was so rad. Well, that was fun. Who would have thought? You utter a name and bam, lightning strike, because it's cursed. And they gave us these new clothes, too. Now that you mention it, isn't it weird? We've lost our clothes, but not those items we found in the lava-flooded room. I'm still not at ease with what they gave me. I'd rather wear something fancier. At least it's blue. Yeah, poor soldier that got struck by the lightning, too. So, yeah, well point out, Knight. poor soldier with his eyes like bulging out like, oh god. Question, where are we? What is this place? It's too well done to be Benjamin scenery. Do you really think this is all scenery? What do you think this castle's made of, cardboard? Chill. Well, tell us, what do you think has happened? Yeah, twice. Got struck twice. I have no idea. Maybe some kind of parallel dimension? Fantasy world? Magic, princesses, monsters, and... fantasy? I don't know. Parallel dimension. It's more than awesome. It's giga-awesome! 100 billion times awesomer! Is it possible? I have no clue. But we're here and we have to deal with it. So, what do we do now? Save the princess? Yeah, it might give us a reward. Maybe a magic item. Or tell us how to go home. So take a look around. Maybe we can find a way back. Okay, let's do it. And maybe we find Benjamin. As a game master, he'd love this place. Nigel learned Darkadeus because, guess what, he learned the name.
Only Nigel can know this one, as you can see. The cursed name of the villain. Radical effect. It hits one random opponent, because you don't get to decide where the lightning strikes, poor soldier. 25 turns, 25 MP to cast. It does 31 to 91. And it's lightning element. I believe that's lightning elemental. It does from meh to wow. So he can have that one. And like they said, we didn't lose any of the stuff we got in the lava-filled room. Except their clothes. Hey, kids, you look like heroes. Thanks, man. Now, don't get too excited. You didn't let me finish. You look like lousy heroes. Need some fancier equipment to become a real hero. Go to a shop, buy some new gear. Remember that weapons, armors, and utilities are specific for each class. So, for instance, you look like a wizard. You'll never be able to equip a sword, heavy armor, or a shield. Look to a magic shop for your needs. And if you have different party members up front, like I'm going to be doing this from like Nigel's point of view, but the cool thing is if you have different people, you get different dialogue. For example, wrong person. For instance, you look like a fighter. Swords, axes, and heavy armors are more suitable for you. Don't waste your time on capes or tunics. So, for instance, you look like, what are you, a bard? I'm a pirate! Whatever you say, kid. Maybe you should focus on ranged weapons. You don't look like the type of hero that throws himself in a brawl. Can't picture you wielding a sword or heavy armor. Maybe some light shirt, some music instrument. You like music, kid? Yes, I do like music. Thanks for the advice. Yeah, so he's going to be more bard-ish than than anything. And lastly. For instance, you look like a rogue. Knives, daggers, short swords, and whips might be your weapons. Use lighter armors, too. There you go. And you get some information about each class. Now, as the characters level up, the bonuses and minuses get more. So, for example, Nigel now gives plus 30 to MP, but minus 6 to spirit. They go up and down. I'm just going to keep them standard for now. Just keep them in the middle. Okay. If you're just as cool as the Bright Warriors. Those were different times. Yes, the Warriors of Bright. The Bright Warriors. Now see, they don't get the reference. That's obviously talking about the Warriors of Light. The Light Warriors from Final Fantasy 1. Again, we're in the initial fantasy chapter. Who are you? What do you want? I have no money for you freaks. Castletown is fairly standard town for adventurers. You can find the magic shop up northwest, Smith's is west, and a nice tavern lies in the east. This guy. My job is to get in the hero's way and slow them down. I know, it's a dirty job, but someone's gotta do it. Yeah, he's that guy. He's the annoying NPC that always gets in your way, but he's just like unabashedly doing it. You know, you've played RPGs. That NPC that always gets in your way, and you have to like shove him out of the way before you can get to a door or whatever. Yeah, that's this guy. Except he's doing it on purpose. East, Diner, Bright Warriors Museum, exit. South, in, exit, west, Smith's. Let's start here. Remember, a good hero never complains about buying stuff.
He has to pay for every sword, shield, and potion. This is our tradition, and the tradition of every RPG. 90% of heroes have humble origins. Most of them start out when they're still kids. That's why most of the starter weapons are cheap and simple to use. That makes sense. How can I help you, young heroes? Here, a long sword. Classic. Nothing more to say. It's a classic. You know, you don't have to, you know, have a funny line for a long sword. It's a long sword. It's a classic. Oh, can't go wrong with a long sword. We'll definitely get that. Sling. It can kill a giant, if you're lucky. And have, you know, magic stones. Buy that. Short sword, a classic, you know, but shorter, because it's a short sword. I'll buy one of those, less damage, but it does give the speed, so our ninja can go more often. The Pride Warriors, no.
Excuse me.
Long sword, sling, short sword. Sell the 2x4s. Sell all the bones. We don't need those. Okay. I'll do it for now. While weapons, utilities, and armors are specific for each class, rings and accessories can be equipped by anyone. I'm looking for an armor to wear at my daughter's wedding.
Oh, neat.
Even if the king calls you heroes, don't expect any kind of discount here. It's tradition that heroes buy their own equipment with no help. Because, you know, RPG. Scale mail, made from real iron scales. Gives more HP, a little more resistance, but less MP. I'm gonna stick with the dragon scale armor. Buckler, small, but handy. Less strength, but gives more evasion and HP. I'm just gonna stick with what we have. Padded armor, quilted cloth for basic protection. Again, I'm gonna stick with the dungeon armor. Sorry. Second knife, it increases your offensive ability in battle. Why? Because ninja. Ninja can dual wield. Now, you don't get two swings or anything, it just acts as an offhand item. But instead of giving you more defense, it gives you more... It counts as a utility item, but instead of giving you more defense or HP, it just gives him more attack. Swing harder. So we'll do that. Best way to win a fight is not losing. Pro tip, kids. In order to learn a power, you need to pay a trainer that teaches you the technique. Then you have to remember to equip the power. Don't forget that. As you can see, these people have exclamation points over their heads. Or a, not exclamation point, sorry, as a light bulb. Can't decide, rogue or warrior, which class should I pick? A warrior can control its enemy's hate, so to draw their attacks on him. Powers with effects like these, hate or mass hate, can be very helpful.
Best defense is a strong offense. What can I teach you?
Power attack for Johnny. Smash your opponent with a powerful attack. 60-88 HP worth of damage, 27 turns, and 25 MP to cast. Warrior challenge. Do damage and also get more hate, so enemies will strike him more. Which is important. He's the warrior. He's typically going to have the most HP and most defense. Unstoppable. It draws a bunch of hate, and it also heals him. A powerful shout that recharges your HP. So not only can it's expensive at 30 MP, but Johnny can heal himself and draw hate at the same time. A useful move. We'll buy all of these. Now you can't equip all of them. because he only has 2 power points. So we're going to equip Unstoppable and Warrior Challenge.
Defense is for weak people. Best strategy is to strike your foes before they even notice you're there. Let's see what I can teach you.
Sneak attack, a must for every rogue. The enemy won't know who hit him. And literally, the enemy won't know who hit him. It gives no hate. So he can do a lot of damage, but the big thing is, you know, no hate. So he can attack and not draw hits. Arm Sunder, break your opponent's arms to lower his strength. Does damage and lower strength. Chop the Throat, a named karate chop to cripple the enemy's spirit. Because, you know, you can't cast as well when you're when you're choking. So, there's those. I am going to give him Arm Sunder and Chop the Throat. Because a rogue plays dirty. No bones about it. Let's see, can I go this way? Quiet, kids. I don't want to miss another student because he's been devoured by a monster. Yeah, that would be bad.
Heard about this magic candle, an item that can light up dark places. Incredible, isn't it? Magic can do such amazing things.
If anybody, no sneak attack because I don't think I have the money to buy everybody's skills. If I do, I'll go back and buy it. But I want to make sure I have enough money for the other skills that I want for the more magic users. Anybody gets the magic candle reference, what game that's from? Kudos. I know what it's from. But I'll be interested to see if anybody else gets what that's from. Lot. We can take all the money because it's just laying out there on the table, and that is within the king's permission. Well done, that's true. It is from a Legend of Zelda series. From both 1 and 2. We need to go this way. Pesky NPC, I swear. Hi kids, guess you have a lot of questions about dexterity, which governs speed and evasion. Speed lets you act before your enemies, and a higher score lets you play more turns during the battle. If you're faster, your actions will require less time. Evasion represents the chance of evading attack, taking no damage. Pretty neat. Remember, kid, never hit your face with your sword. It's important. Dude, check this out. And the, the pirate is in the pub. By the no, Shalakor, don't secure your items, Kingdom Hearts. No, it is by the king's privilege. I get to take everything from the houses that I want, but I have to buy my own gear because that is tradition. Strength spirit. This alcoholic beverage raises your strength and spirit. So, on 1 ally, it raises both strength and spirit. Pretty useful. A Molotov cocktail. An explosive drink for your enemy. Better served hot. Cost 28 turns, 25 MP to cast. It has the fire element, obviously. Because it's a Molotov cocktail. And I believe it can burn the enemy. Everything out in the open, though. Yeah? Far southeast, there is a small town on a river called Rivertown. It's a nice place. It's also the only place where you can buy pizza. Delicious. And healing. So make note of that. Rivertown to the southeast is where you can buy pizza. Can't complain about not being able to eat rations whenever you want. It's our tradition that you can eat and drink one ration only after a battle. Because tradition. Hi, gentlemen. What do you need? Food, cola, rations? Do you know how to use rations? Should I eat them? Well, yes, but no. Rations are automatically used after each battle, and they heal 25% of your HP or MP, but only if you need them. Can I use them whenever I'm hungry? No, you can't. Consider rations as a reward for winning a battle, as a kind of feast, party. I love feasts. So that's how rations work. There's food and water rations. After you win a battle, you get 25% of your HP or MP back. It's to help keep you going outside when you're going through a dungeon. But you can't use them whenever you want. You can only use them after winning a battle. For in-battle items, jelly beans, potato chips, orange juice, Loca-Cola. Dude to the right looks like me. Dude to the left looks like me. Yeah. Notice that people who talk about light bulbs are trainers willing to teach you some special powers. Yeah, pretty neat. I'll buy rations and stuff later. Orcus created his hideout far to the east. You can't reach it straight away because of the mountains. Just go southeast and then north. Had a lot of heroes, each of them chosen by Destiny, but none of them became famous like the Bright Warriors did. This is their hometown. By the way, the Bright Warrior Museum. Then he says, picnic like a huge turkey. I've always been a fan of the Bright Warriors, even if their latest quests aren't as good as the old one. I know, I'm a skeleton. So what? Can I be a Bright Warriors fan? No. Sorry guys, but you'll have to wait in line as everybody else. I love Bright Warriors because they understand my emo nature. So, there's all that. Hey, it's Black Mage. I think we can do something for that later. I really need to find the mage trainer. I'll tell you a secret about Grit. Not only is it a basic ability for a critical hit and experience, it also gives you a bonus to EXP. That's where it is. Shalakor, you were asking why the EXP was off. That's why. Because some characters had more grit than others. That's why it's off. The more grit you have, the more EXP you get. Remember, you didn't hear it from me. There it is. I knew there was a reason, I just couldn't remember. Must find mage training. Maybe in the south part of town. There's the inn. Pro tip, save often. That's a good idea. 40 goals for one night. Now I'm good. Sleeping is the best way to heal yourself. When you're on the world map, look for camps, small villages, and towns where you can rest. This room needs some furniture. It's so cheap. Yeah, there's nothing in that room. That's true. Nope, that's the world map. Press space in the world map to display a mini-map. The red dot is your current position. Gray ones are places you discover. Hold on, I'm not done yet. This way. The unnamed is up to something. I can feel it. If only I were a hero, I'd go kill that demon myself. But I'm not, so it's up to you. Thanks, guy. Should. Feel free to steal from my house. Gee, thanks. Hero's privilege! Potato chips. Jelly beans. That's it. Pretty sure. Air's magic shot. Fireball will burn all your enemies with just one strike. A burnt character has strength and spirit reduced by 10 points. How can magic help you? Magic potion recovers, yes, removes a lot of different status effects. Also gives you 33% HP and 33% MP back. Of course, it also costs 50. It's super expensive. Aspirin cures a few negative status effects. Cures the status effects, it just doesn't get rid of other stuff. Man, isn't aspirin great? Also, it gives you 5 HP back. 5% HP back. But it removes status effects. Thanks, aspirin. KO, we have 4 of those, though. Magic candle. Magic candle that never dies out. We'll go ahead and buy one of those. See, it's usable passive on no one. It's just passive. A simple weapon for a simple wizard. Gives way less strength, but it does give a lot of spirit. Also, there's a wooden flute, perfect for training bards. Instead of the slingshot, the ranged attack, you can go this route and give him more HP and more spirit. Magic singlet. Just a normal singlet, but magical. Equip that. Magical stuff. Give a little extra to your magic, just because. Blue cape, because you're a wizard. And wand. Grab all those. We're gonna grab some aspirin. 10 of them should suffice. For now anyway, while I don't have a lot of money. Buy magical stuff and equip everybody. Wand. Blue cape. Magical stuff instead of the sunglasses. And magical singlet. Alright. We're good. Sell the shovels. I should probably keep a shovel. Just in case the game lets me, like, dig for something. Cardboard helmet. Okay. Ice Blast could do a lot of damage on a single target and can slow it down by freezing him. Pretty useful. A frozen character has speed and evasion reduced by 10 points. I could teach a few spells upon payment. Fireball and Ice Blast. That is, I did the gold exactly right. That's why we didn't get sneak attack. Not yet, anyway. Fire explosion that ignites all your foes. All enemies get hit. Not a lot of damage, 28 to 42. But it hits everybody. And it costs 60 MP to cast. Expensive. But it hits everybody. Ice Blast. Costs 28 turns. 30 MP to cast. 64 to 96 HP. Has the ice element. Can cause freezing. It's just a very powerful single damage attack. Buy that as well. Now the mage has all these spells. But can't use them all. We're gonna take fire, we're gonna take magic missile off. And I'm gonna use fireball because we're gonna level up a bit. I should also throw everybody else's powers on. We'll go strength and spirit. Okay, good. Alright, I'm broke. I think per typical beginning of RPG fashion, we should level up. House creeps me out. It's just magic. So there's that. All right. save the game. Spacebar is the minimap. So you can see there's a minimap, which is really cool. Gray Wolf. And I guess I should show some of these off. Arm Sunder. This'll stop you, and you're dead. Yes, the wolf just talked to us. Oh, got crit. Yay, cola. My name is Wolf. Can't let you do that. Yeah, it's a really big minimap. I like it. Because I can actually see what's on the minimap. Gray Wolf, and see, the wolf's got different stuff. This one has like a bow. This one has sunglasses. Chop the throat. Shut up. Exactly. You should go sell some of that, Doc. Heal the ninja. Warrior challenge. Bring it on. And I can show off Dragadeus because there's only one enemy left. Dead. Remember, that one has like a wide range of damage, so I'm glad it did enough. 30 cash and potato chips. And my name is Wolf. And I can hear it thundering outside, so if I disappear, you'll know what happened. Thieves and a bard. Well, we have to chop the throat of the bard, right? I mean, yeah. Break your spirit. This will stop your attacks. Yeah, as he got beat up. You. One of you got hit. Aww. Heal. I'm sorry that it's been freezing a lot. I hope that's not my fault. I don't know. Can you respec spent ability points in this game? Like the strength, grit, all of that? I don't know. What you're seeing now is just about as far as I've been, actually. I told you, I didn't get very far. I got, like, through the beginning. That's it. I thought there was a way to use the powers outside of battle. Cast. There it is. Yeah, you just cast. There we go. There might be a way to get your points respect. I'm not sure though. I can't say for sure. There's one. Warrior challenge. Oh no, you're gonna die from it. I'll just kill one of you then. You're dead. Next. When you get hit. Oh, and it did enough damage. Awesome. Fine for me. I have two strings up and playing a game. Heal. Heal a spaghetti monster. And death. There we go. That was quite a bit of money. Hocus pocus. You have these little villages out here that you can visit. Well, little farms and stuff. You're expecting to find any treasure. You'll be disappointed. Only horse shit and bird drops, my friends.
I'll tell you a secret. Press space in the world map to display a small map of the world.
Literally, crap. Real crap. Like that, he said, that's all they have. Chickens, why? Jelly beans. Bye. Loca-Cola.
Heroes, so the words are true. I hope you defeat the evil unnamed. I heard he's a really mean. A true villain.
Free aspirin. Happy for that. Never know when status effects are gonna bite you. And you can see that a gray diamond appears. A gray diamond appears. That means that you've been to that place, which is cool. One last time. Chop the throat of the bard. All right. By the way, you can hold space bar and you get to see like the battle log, which is pretty useful. Just in case you want to see anything. Mercs. Hero my ass. Oh yeah? How big and bad are you now? And I haven't shown off fireballs, so I'm gonna fireball this last one anyway. Fire at will! I like the effect of fireball. All we can do now is attack, so I'm just gonna hold, you hold left control down and just fast forwards battle. Everybody attacks at like double speed. Okay, if you want to just get through a battle with basic attacks, can't use skills, so you'll have to be a little careful there. Stay. Yay, music. Alright, chat is like slow. I don't know if people are getting tired, but chat is like slowly calmed down. We still having fun, chat? We still good? You enjoying the game? Let's take a look. Head this way. The place we're supposed to be going is to the right, I believe, so why not go somewhere else. You're gonna go down. Both the bards will get to go. Yes, yes, that's good. No more mana! That's right, the bard just sapped away like half the mana. You can all be hit with a fireball because of it. So good, just getting sleepy. Ahoy, and other nautical expressions. As you can see, pretty big map. There's a lot to explore. Oh, didn't kill. fireball you anyway. This map looks very similar to Millennium. Well, Millennium is an RPG Maker game, so... Or in that vein. And I don't think the map looks that similar. Potato chips and cola. I'm going to head back. Because really, I just need some money because I want to, before we go to a dungeon or something, I want to buy some rations. Crazy chicken! If only the mage went first. Just fireball all of them. Heal the ninja. Only 25 HP, so we can take care of it. Oh, so close. Hey, food rations, because chicken. Angry birds! Get it, angry birds? Fireball! Fire at will! Here we go. So close! Level 5. Crazy chicken. So... blah, blah, from Zelda. Possibly. That's possibly. I'm just going to dump everything into Charisma for more MP and Spirit. We're going to go 2 into Charisma for more MP and 1 into Grit. And... three into Dex. Oh, so close to My Name is Wolf. And because they leveled, everybody gets all their HP and MP back. You were wondering about that. No, Bard. Not taking away my MP again. You get to go. But we can get rid of this guy before he gets a chance to go. And let's see if we get lucky. Yep. Well, I didn't get the one I wanted, but still killed. There you go. Fist just got stronger, and 3 points into strength for the fighter. Money. Hocus pocus. This guy must be the chicken whisperer. Dodge. Welcome back! There we go. Food ration. And Angry Birds, Hocus Pocus. And, we've been eating the food rations too. So people get their HP back. That means we don't have to spend as much money out here. That's what I wanted. I wanted the wolves. Yeah, ow. So close. Jeez, Francis is getting beat up. Yay! And because we finished My Name is Wolf, at least the bronze star, we get Wolf Sandwich. Tastes horribly. But it heals 100 HP and 100 MP. A useful thing for getting that. Now people can put on more skills. Ice Blast, Power Attack, Molotov Cocktail, and I can go buy Sneak Attack. I'll heal on the way up. See? I didn't forget about Sneak Attack. Get Sneak Attack there. And put it on. Yes, having fun getting paperwork together. Gotcha. Just grinding. Yay. Head this way. Northwest Castletown, Northeast Holy Church, Southeast Rivertown. Oh, why don't we check this place out after one of these chickens dies? Cock-a-doodle-doo! And we get rid of the bard. And dead. Aw, no rations. Almost done with Angry Birds. Jelly beans. Our beloved Destiny, the Emperor. I might be old, but the Emperor is older than me. But since he's immortal, he doesn't get grumpy and bald as me. Now get off my lawn! There's a pup here. Nuns up north are weird. Give a lot of tips about fighting. Once my cousin, when he was a kid, died. Now he's fine. I think he used a 1-up to get better. Extra lives do that. Quite a boring village. Only distractions are random encounters and the church at north. Damned wolves. While coming here, I got caught in a random encounter with three of them. One bit me and I started to bleed, losing HP after every round. Luckily, after 5 rounds, I stopped bleeding. So there's some actual good information. Bleed lasts 5 rounds. Hi, gentlemen. How can I serve you? Jelly beans, potato chips, ocean juice, orange juice, Coca-Cola, food, and water rations. Me a bunch of orange juice so you can heal outside of battle with a heal brews and then just drink orange juice. If you enjoyed Doom and Destiny, help it with a good rating. Tell a friend or support it on the magic web, known as the internet, with a comment, a review, or through social network. Or do what I'm doing and show it off through the internet via a Twitch stream. See? I'm helping. If you're enjoying this game, please consider getting Doom and Destiny for yourself. To the rating machine, to the Facebook, nope, this game sucks. Well, it's none of those. I really like this game, but I'm doing my way to help. Well, you suck more! Angry face! No, I'm helping this game because it seems like none of you have heard of it, so I'm doing my part of showing this game off. 40 goals for one night, so same price here. Plan to go southeast. Here there's a lovely town on the riverside. You notice that most of the other houses don't have beds? I have not noticed that. Aspirin! You're looking around for the Orcus's lair. Go south until you reach a town on the riverbank. Cross the mountain path at east and head northwest. You're looking for something else. Good luck with that. Wolves these days, going around with money and stuff. What has become of society? My opinion, it's all on Name's fault. Because you noticed we were getting money from the from fighting the wolves. I might be old, but the Emperor is older than me. But since I've talked to that guy already. Sorry, man, he went a long way. He went all the way up there. I need him out of the way, though, so I can go up north. Blessed. Let me just reset the town. it just leads me north. I thought we had to go different to get here. Statue of our beloved Emperor, Destiny. A statue of the first Afro-American mage. Neat! Get it? Do you get it? A statue of a generic hero. Thanks, generic hero. By the way, why is this one blinking? You got me, but don't tell it to anybody. Statue of an elf hero. So, there you go. Statue of a dwarf hero. That's alive. There we go, that's how you get down. Secret found. Inside here, there's a free one up, and a super magic potion, and another one up. Super Magic Potion. This super magic juice will heal 66% of your max HP and MP and more. We'll be super saving that. Must get money. Secret found. And there's 150 cash. That'll be useful. Let's take a look what we got here. Heard that the unnamed eats children without washing his hands before. Unbelievable. I'll let that one sink in. When an attack has a staggering effect, the victim will be stunned and slowed for a bit. Use those attacks wisely, since you can push back your enemy on the battle line. Maybe act before them. Yeah, that's the same thing. Be aware of the evil unnamed. He can be anywhere with his dark powers. Even here! Just kidding. Might be useful to you. Negative state... Let's see. Wasn't the Emperor that played D&D while you were porting around a while back? At least it used the same sprite as the statues. It did use the same sprite as the statues, didn't it? Maybe it was. That'd be super interesting. I kinda hope that's the case now. I don't know. I hope it's the case, though. Burnt, frozen, sleepy, bleeding, even knocked out. Wears off at the end of battle. Be careful where you step. High grass and woods double your chance to be attacked by enemies. Foes always attack the adversary whom they have the most grudge in battle. Dealing damage, even healing yourself, will raise their hate. If you're low on HP, don't provoke your opponent or he will attack you. Let who is more healthy damage him, so he'll get distracted. warrior can control its enemies' hate, so to draw their attacks on them. Powers with effects like hate can be very helpful.
What can God teach you? Smite evil!
Yeah, I like this. Let me go back to smite evil. For the purpose of this magic blow, your foe is always evil. Which I love that, because that's such a D&D reference. It's a paladin. I play paladins quite a bit. You smite evil, but then the character wasn't really evil, so your use of smite evil was wasted. Not here! Foe's always considered evil. Gives hate with a plus, so it gives like extra hate. And does damage in battle. Lightning orb. Zap and stagger your enemy with a lightning orb. Heal wound. Not only does it heal HP, it also gets rid of negative states. Super heal wound. Gives more HP, it's more expensive. But it also removes status effect downs as well. Or stat down. Smooth criminal. You don't need luck. It's not just a lot of skills. You got struck by... Anyway. Godspeed. God gives you speed. And gives you a bonus to speed. Stunning fist. Guess what it does? Staggers. It's a fist. Now these are expensive, so I need money. I'll take heal wound. Because it's a better heal bruise. Speed up. Lightning orb, because it stuns. And stunning fist. We need to get the money to buy the rest. Instead of Daria Deus, which is hilarious, we'll go lightning orb. This music is surprisingly relaxing. It is. Instead of heal bruise, it costs 5 more MP, but we'll go heal wound because it actually heals. Because it heals more, for 5 more MP, it'll be really useful. Now, Godspeed is a passive, but you still have to pay the 1 power point to equip it. But while you have it equipped, you get that bonus, which I will do. You see, it's always active. And it gives you a boost to stats, but you have to put on the, but you have to spend the power point on it. So you have those type of skills too. So you get some different skills to use, which is really cool. Different types of skills to use. Watch out for the dark crypt. It's a dark place, and when I say dark, I mean there's no light. Crypt is where we bury our failed attempts at hero summoning. Be careful, they can be very aggressive. I don't know if I should be doing this. But we have the light, so because candle. Electrified 4 in memory of... No, really. Watch out for the electric floor. There's another one in this crypt. Here lies Chester, killed by drugs abuse. That's sad. I have a grave problem. That robot couldn't stop running. Who programmed it? Express train was too fast. Well, that's why you pay attention. Defeated to death in a school fight by a fat nerd shooting energy from his mouth. Huh. What a way to go. Don't know what that's a reference to. That has to be a reference to something. Here lies player. Here lies AAA. These are funny. These are old school references. If anybody gets this, like AAA and ASS, You get that, Eagle Claw. I know you get that. For those of you that don't get it, it's what a lot of people would put in arcade machines, because you can like put your initials. And so those were used a lot. Just AAA, just to get through it really fast. Here lies a cute thing that died horribly. Well, now I want to use a 1-up on it. Yeah, arcade names for high score. See, Eagle Claw got it. Defeated by old age. There you go. Wasn't fast enough, has been crushed by the screen. Man. Count the number of times that's happened to me. Die, die, die. Super Skeletron. Skeletron and skeletons. You're pretty soon. I didn't die. Hit again. I don't know how long I'm going to be in here, but fireball! Fire at will! Get rid of those two. Yeah, of course you hit the mage after all that aggro take. And dead. Hey, got some orange juice. Awesome. And 36 gold. And potato chips. There's the electrified floor. Pay attention to it. Money! You found Black Tunic. A 1-up. This looks fancy. Bard Hat. Know who that's gonna go to. Ah, right before I go in the menu. So lame. You're dead. And Skeletal Wizard can die. Heal Wound. Heal Spaghetti Monster, except for more. This'll shock you. Lightning Orb. You're dead. No, that wasn't cool. That's not cool at all. You're not allowed to do that much damage. Now I want some tater chips. Because of all the potato chips. Potato chips and a bone. Now I can go in here and... One... Do that. And then two. Black Tunic. Its dark nature will help you stay alive. Better than the blue cape we have on. 20 more HP and 5 more MP. Bard Hat. Superfly. I have a bag of Cheetos, but I don't want to get orange all over the keyboard. Man, I can go for some Cheetos. Bard Hat, more MP, more spirit, but less HP and strength from the tankard, but gotta switch out eventually. We'll go with the Bard Hat. Okay. Let's get... Ow! Dodged it the first time, didn't dodge it that time. Good job, me. We're gonna explore the rest of this after I go heal. There's no place to heal here, though. But I can grab Super Heal Wound. Well, that would make it to where I can't buy two. I'll just buy two and buy Super Heal Wound later. Well, the healer in me. Buy Super Heal Wound. And, oh yeah, I do have enough. Smite Evil. Instead of Power Attack, Smite Evil. And I shove the bag in your face and go full feed bag. 4 Cheetos.
So expensive.
I like him having all the speed. I'll keep super heal wound just for later. And put it on later. Alright. Need to get into a fight. Vulcan Nerf Punch! Yes, that is the stunning fist, by the way. Because it can be. I think he said punch. You know, it's a Vulcan Nerf Pinch, but I don't think he says pinch. I think he says punch. Because, can't say the exact same thing, of course. Ice Blast, because I'm not showing it off. Freeze! I still don't have enough. Hold on. Hit Bard. Kill a Bard. No, he just saved Vulcan Nerf Pinch. Awesome. Aw, sleep. The healer has officially passed out. We're gonna smite evil just because. Smite the evil! Because I can. And fire at will. Not quite enough. Now you're dead. Yeah, fireball doesn't do a lot of damage, but it hits everything. Now we have money to stay at the inn. No problem. Yay. No, I don't need to stay again. Let's go back and explore that place, because we found some cool stuff there. Mm-hmm. Actually, we'll continue exploring that place next stream. I'm gonna cut this one short just because of Jake Cocoon 2 ran extra long. Save often. It's true. Save often. It kind of would have been cooler as Vulcan Nerf Punch just to change it up. That would have been funny. But anyway, I'm gonna cut the stream off early. It'd be the same time it normally would be, but it'll just be short because started late because Jade Cocoon 2 ran extra long. Before I go, chat, let me know first impressions of the game. You interested to see more? You liking it? You having a lot of fun with it? Like the references and stuff like that. You know, let me know, because I'm sure there is plenty more where this came from. Yes, more. Thanks to Drow, it's a great game. So much fun. Hilarious. Liked it so far. Good. I'm glad I chose it. I was struggling to love it. Want to see some anime references. I know there's a whole bunch of references in here. References to anything popular. So, at the time this game was made. So, quite entertaining. Have fun on Neptune. I don't understand the have fun on Neptune part, but glad it's entertaining. Just a blank thing. Oh, okay. There's the image popped up. The image was slow. Quite nice. I don't think it's great, but nice anyways. Okay. Good. Hopefully you're still having fun with it anyway. Good. Pretty positive all the way around from what I've what I see here, so that's good. Thanks for being here, stream. I appreciate it, chat, and I'm glad you enjoyed it so far and having a lot of fun with it. There'll be more references and things like that. It's a decent RPG. It's nothing spectacular from an RPG perspective yet, but there may be some stuff later, but just the skills are interesting enough. Well, thanks for staying up, Maze, and checking it out. So that's what's going to be here at this time slot, which is 6 p.m. Central Time to 9 p.m. Central Time. That's what's going to be on Thursdays. That's what's going to be here till we get through the game, which will be a lot of fun. Until the next stream, again, thanks for dropping by and having a lot of fun. If you're not following the Twitch channel, please follow the Twitch channel. You get updates whenever I start to stream, because I'm going to be streaming more when games come out in a couple of months. Oh, okay. I got you, Shalakor. follow the Twitch channel. Subscribe to the YouTube channel if you're watching this later. Please subscribe to my channel. And until next stream, I'm Cinder89. Remember to shoot for the stars and take care, everyone.